to Maxim's Inside Track. Hope you've been keeping well. Still an extremely volatile world and dairy market out there, and I suspect will continue to be so. Plenty of geopolitical tensions around the world. US, China, still Australia, China, Brexit, UK, and EU, and what that might look like. And also just, the second wave of COVID, or talk of that, and some increases in other regions of COVID as well. So I'll kick this one off with full cream milk powder. A very positive result on the GDT, up a couple of percent, and in particular the front couple of contracts well supported above that number, and then drifts off beyond that. We're starting to see the disparity between regular whole milk and instant whole milk close back down to usual type numbers, just over that $100 a tonne premium. I think whole milk powder will hinge primarily on China demand. We have seen actual liquid milk prices in China starting to decline, which would mean they've got a surplus of milk in China, which they're looking to place. New Zealand has also been relatively strong on milk flows. So yeah, we'll look to the new season. Milk prices, opening milk prices in New Zealand are reasonably strong as well, which should encourage milk flows. So I think China demand, and we're looking sort of sideways-ish for this product category. On a skim milk powder now, a positive result on GDT, up 3%+. We are seeing the actual global milk pool still up about 1%+. So milk not burning off just yet. China demand for skim a little bit weaker. A good result, right across GDT further out on all the contracts, which was encouraging. Private storage in Europe for skim, there's only about 10,000 tonnes gone into private storage over there on skim milk powder, which is encouraging. However, I just can't see skim running away from us, and I suspect for the next sort of quarter or a couple of quarters to be relatively stable-ish around these numbers. Moving on to the fats now, butter and AMF. We've seen European prices slowly starting to drift up. The demand from this food service category has certainly popped up initially, an initial pipeline fill, and then we're now starting to see some patchy demand around that. NZ offerings and Australian offerings on butter are available now, and starting to come back into line with sort of European prices. So we expect this category to maybe even drift off a little bit further, just depending on food service demand. Cream prices in Europe have been reasonably well supported. It's just a matter of how this COVID looks, and opening up of these food service restaurants and clubs and pubs, etc., and then how well patronised they will be. So, interesting sector. I'm erring on the side of caution, probably drifting off a little bit further. Moving on to cheddar now. Seen some, once again, strong food service demand, which is pop pricing back up slightly, in particular in the US. I think I commented on it last time, but we've seen a pretty radical V-shape in the block and barrels over there, and it's still holding up reasonably well. I suspect that it could drift off a little bit. Australia and New Zealand offerings are still quite expensive to the other parts of the world, and I expect sideways for this category. Retail demand will play a part, and that's been relatively strong, once again coming back to some sort of normality. So I think just depending on where milk gets allocated, sideways for this category. to whey and lactose now. This category's been supported a little bit just by the, as we've gone into COVID and food service demands decline for cheeses, that's reduced the amount of whey available. So that's underpinned whey powder in particular. Lactose demand is still strong, in particular from that infant formula side of things. We've seen some significant investment in China or back into the swine or pig area, so we think that that'll underpin sort of permeate lactose and whey demand into China. On the actual protein side of it, WPC's stable-ish, and we think there's a little bit of pressure on the whey protein isolates, a smaller category, and yeah, it's a bit patchy. Online sales buoyant, gym sales, etc. Chemists drifting off. However, we have started to see gyms reopen, which could start to support this category a little bit further. That's it for me. Thank you very much for listening to Maxim Foods Inside Track, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Thanks.